morning po ulit sa ating lahat. And now, ito naman po tayo sa ating daily devotional. And we're happy sa inyong patuloy na pagsusubaybay sa activity na ito. Papalapit na po ang Pasko, and I hope that you are all excited to celebrate, rejoice, and fill our hearts with love and joy as we wait for this day na ipinanganak ang ating Panginoong Hesukristo. And since it's Christmas season, this morning we're going to talk about the birth of Christ, ang kapanganakan ni Jesus dito sa mundo. And titingnan din natin kung paano ito nagbigay ng hope, di lang sa mga tao sa time ng New Testament, hindi kung paano din ito nagbigay ng hope in times noong sa Old Testament. Especially when Israel has been taken captive by the Assyrians. At kung paano ito ma-apply sa mga buhay natin as Christians in these difficult times. So, let's open our Bibles in Isaiah chapter 9, verses 1 to 7. I'm gonna read Isaiah chapter 9, verse 1. Nevertheless, the gloom will not be upon her who is distressed, as when at first he lightly esteemed the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, and afterward more heavily oppressed her by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan in Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. You have multiplied the nation and increased its joy. They rejoice before you according to the joy of harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For you have broken the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every warrior's sandal from the noisy battle and garments rolled in blood will be used for burning and fuel of fire. Verse 6, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Verse 7, of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end, upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. And, amen. And to understand this passage, see Isaiah, which means the Lord is salvation. Yan po yung ibig sabihin ng name ni Isaiah. The Lord is salvation. Yahweh is salvation. Is a prophet sa time na na-conquer ng Assyria ang northern kingdom, which is Israel, and ang southern kingdom din ng Judah is na-threaten ng surrounding nations sa time na yon. Kasi in those times, yung malalakas ang mga empires kagaya ng Babylon at Egypt at puno ng takot at distress ang mga Israelites and the people of Judah. And this is the main message of Isaiah, na even though na-conquer sila ng mga kalaban, ililigtas sila ng Panginoon. So, in this passage, let's see kung paano ito pinakita ni Isaiah sa ang message of hope sa Israel at Judah in this passage. So, verse 1 to 2, ipinakita ang promise to Israel na sila nakaunang nag-suffer sa Assyrian Empire. But sabi dyan, they will see the light from the Lord. God will remove the gloom from their distress. And how will God give this light to his people? Let's continue with the verse 3 to 5. Sabi dyan, the people walking in darkness, they saw a great light. May nakita daw silang great light. Isang liwanag, isang hope. And napaka-interesting yung susunod na verses is kung paano to sinabi ni Isaiah, paano niya in-address ni Isaiah this great light as you, this person, sabi dyan, have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. So Isaiah pointed out that this great light is someone who is coming and will do all of this for the deliverance of the nation of Israel. Yan. Sinabi dyan, you have multiplied the nation, they will rejoice before you. Itong great light na, this hope na, na ipapakita ng Panginoon. And I'm pretty sure na alam natin kung sino itong taong ito na pinaprofesay ni Isaiah. To make sure, let's look at the final verses, yung verses 6 to 7. Sabi dyan, "For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." Yan. And this is familiar sa ating mga Christmas songs. Kasi because this verse is directly describing Christmas. Kung ano talaga ang ibig sabihin ng Pasko. At ito ay ang kapanganakan ni Jesus, the Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Usually kapag narinig natin ang Pasko, ang pumapasok sa atin is mga regalo. And this should point us sa pinakadakilang regalo na binigay sa atin. "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given." Verse 7, "He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom." Ang Messiah daw is mga galing sa line ni David. Kaya makita natin sa Gospels, pinakita dyan yung birth, yung sa birth of Christ, pinakita ang genealogy patungo kay Jesus to confirm na siya talaga ang hope, ang Messiah na manggagaling kay, sa line ni David. Now, ang message na ito is nagbigay ng hope sa Israel at nagdulot sa kanila upang mag-look forward at maghintay sa araw na ito, sa araw na ipinanganak si Jesus, sa araw ng Pasko. And now, I want us Christians to know na, alam ko na we have been through a lot this year of 2020. Marami tayong naranasang paghirap sa taong ito. Pero let's remind ourselves na kahit gaano man kasaklap ang taong ito, mayroon pa rin Paskong darating sa taong ito. And I want us to, as we celebrate Christmas, let us remind ourselves na darating ulit ang Panginoong Jesus. He will come again. At dahil dito sabi nga ni Paul sa 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 to 18, sabi niya, "Rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances." Bakit nito nasabi ni Paul? Dahil Christ will come again soon. And this time, it is now our hope as we look forward to that time, that day. So let us always be encouraged that no matter how difficult the times of our times, the Savior will come again in the future. Okay? So let's pray. Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for your words that you've given us. Thank you for the message of hope that you reminded us, Lord. Thank you for this day that we can look forward to, that we can always rejoice and we can always give thanks and we can always give our all. Even though we are facing these difficult times, we thank you for your strength that you've given us. We thank you for the hope that is in Jesus, Lord. Bring you back all the glory and honor. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.